Hi everybody, welcome back with me in English Mind. Today I'm going to be here with you in Unit 8, Tourism, and section A Close Look 1. Before we start, let's take a look on compound nouns. So I'll have you something with compound nouns. You take a very quick look on this. So house, a compound noun written, and how is it formed, and how the word stress goes, and how plurals goes. Okay, so how is a compound noun written? How? Yes, there are three ways that a compound noun can be written. One word, in only one word, for example, bedroom or grandfather. Only one word, bedroom, go together, grandfather, go together, in only one word. Well, with a hyphen between the words, the hyphen, okay? For example, mother-in-law, living room, or check-in, that kind of thing. With two separate words, with a space between the two words, for example, tour guide is a compound noun with two separate words. Sports centers or lunch time, like this. Okay, so there are three ways that compound nouns can be written. Okay, how is it formed? How many ways is compound nouns formed? Okay, there are a lot of ways that a compound noun can be formed. Example, noun. The first one is noun. For example, toothpaste, bathroom, car park, bus stop, like this. So two nouns go together. The second way is noun combined with a verb, like haircut, rainfall, burst off, like this. The third way is adjective at noun, like blackboard, electric light, highway, whiteboard, like this. The fourth way is verb ing at noun, like swimming pool, washing machine, that kind of thing. There are four very common ways of forming an adjective noun, right? So and a compound noun, right? So very, very common ways. Besides, I would like you to look at this particle. A particle can be form a compound noun. What is a particle? A particle can be a preposition or an adverb. Okay, so you look at four ways here. Particle noun, particle verb or verb particle can be used to form a compound noun. Example, particle with a noun, inside, outside, underground, upstairs, downstairs, like this. Or a noun at particle like passerby, hangerby. What does it mean to hangerby? Yeah. So particle at verb like output, input, intake, etc. So verb and particle like take away, take over, check out, check in. Okay, so these are the ways that a compound noun can be formed, right? A lot of way. And now, how would stress go? How would stress goes in a compound noun? Yeah, you can listen to this. For example, here, toothpaste, bedroom, car park, bus stop, blackboard, highway. So how the stress goes? Yes, normally the stress is on the first word, toothpaste, not toothpaste, bedroom, not bedroom. Okay, yes, it's stress words normally. Okay, one of the first word, right? How plural goes? How plural now? For example, bedrooms. One bedroom, two bedroom. How the plural go? Yeah, we put the S at the ends of the word. Okay? Normally, a bus stop, two bus stops, right? You put the S or the ES at the last word, at the end of the last word. Car park, one car park, two car parks, like this, normally. But there are some difference. Example, like a mother-in-law, two mothers-in-laws. Be careful with this. Or like a passerby, two passers-by, a hanger-on, two hangers-on. So normally the S go at the end of the word, but in some words like this or like this, be careful. Okay, so here is all about compounds now. Copy it and try to remember it. Okay, so now get back to our lesson today. A closer look one. Let's take a look at what we have today. Sis activity 1 to 6 here. So let's get started with activity number 1. Mat is word or phrase with a definition. Here is activity 1. Mat is word phrase with a definition. So six definitions and six given words. You read the definition and you choose the words. Okay, I'll help you. One, a journey usually for relaxation, okay? To visit different places. So a journey for pleasure is a tour, right? A tour is a journey for pleasure. Two, a place where a lot of people go on holiday. A place. So it is a resort, right? The act or activity of moving from one to another place. So the activity of moving. Yeah, traveling. Travel, okay? For a person who shows tourists around, or who shows person is tour guide, okay? A short journey to a place, especially for pleasure. A journey in a short time is a trip, okay? Number 6, an organized journey to a place that is not easy to reach. That is an expedition. Okay. Activity 2, fill in blank with a word from the list. There are two extra words. Here is activity 2, fill this blank with a word from the list. There are two extra words, so let's take a look. A paragraph with 8 blanks, but 10 given words, so there are two extra words. Okay, so you read the text and you choose the word to fill in it. Now I'll help you. Would you like to explore an exciting location? Do you want to a beautiful relaxing bit? So want to do somewhere, do a bit, travel to a bit, right? Go to a bit and help to save the environment, or have to save the environment. If the answer is yes, then you should your holiday with eco tour. So you should what? Book holiday with Eco Tours. Eco Tours is the name of a traveling agency or a traveling company, right? A name. At Eco Tours, we help you enjoy your holiday and learn more about places you Places you visit, yeah? Visit a place, right? Visit. In addition, eco-tours give $1 of the cost of your trip to help protect local environment. Environment. Yes, very nice. So, yes, $1 from your cost is spent on local environment. Beautiful action. Okay. Now, call us today to talk with one of your our experience tour. Tour what? Yes, tour guides. Tour guides. We'll help you choose and planning a stimulating that right for you holiday, right? Stimulating holiday that's right for you. Our holidays are definitely not boring, definitely, certainly, right? Definitely not boring. Don't worry about the costs, don't worry about the money you pay, right? Our prices are very reasonable. Our prices are very reasonable. Right price, right? Right price. Not too expensive, not too cheap. Reasonable. Okay. Call right now at 048-555-6788. You'll be with your eco tour vacation. You'll be what? You'll be pleased. You'll be happy. Okay. Activity number 3. Use the words below to complete the compound nouns that match the definition. Activity 3. Use the words below to complete the compound nouns that match the definitions. So here are compound nouns. Okay, we have learned at the beginning of the lesson, okay? That the ways of forming compound noun. So you take a look on here. Six given definition and six words, right? So you read and you complete the compound nouns. I'll help you. A feeling of tiredness and confusion about time after a long plane journey. A very long plane journey, and you feel really tired. We call it jet lag. Jet lag. Jet lag is the tiredness after a plane, right? After a flight. Okay. 2. A disadvantage or problem that makes something a less attractive idea. Okay, very easy one. Drawback. Drawback. Bad point. Bad point. Okay. Number 3. A thought stays somewhere between two parts of journey. Okay. A thought stay. A thought stay in a journey. Okay. Like break time. Okay. That kind of thing. We call it stop, stop over. A popular time of the year for holidays. We call it peak season. Peak season. Okay, popular time for holiday in a year. 5. The place where you go first, when you arrive at the airport to show your ticket. Or oh, easy one, check what? Yes. Check in. Okay. And a place at the side of the road marked with a sign where bus stop. Or oh, easy one is bus stop. Okay. So once again, we have sit compound nouns, jet lag, drawback, stopover, peak season, check-in, bus stop. Good. Activity 4. Complete the sentences using the compound nouns below. Here is activity 4. Complete the sentences using the compound nouns below. So there are 6 sentences and 6 given words, 6 given compound nouns. So you read the sentence and you complete it. Okay, I'll help you. 1. The time is 12 noon at this hotel. The what? The swimming pool time or the checkout time? The checkout, maybe, right? The checkout time is 12 noon at this hotel, right? Let's make sure that we stay at the hotel with a... Yeah, hotel with a swimming pool. Swimming pool, right? Let's make sure. Yet, be certain. There was a, with our tickets, we were charged for one-way tickets and not a round trip. Oh, okay. So, here is a mistake, a mishap, a mistake with our tickets, right? Something wrong happened with our tickets. The motorway was blocked because there are the motorway away is blocked because there had been a pileup. A pileup is an accident in which there are a lot of cars crushed together, that kind of thing. After, please remain seated until the aircraft comes to a standstill outside the terminal building. Ah, so here's a landing. After landing, landing is touchdown, right? Touchdown, landing, right? A plane is landing. Okay. Number 6, at the hotel, you can choose between a bed and breakfast or bed and breakfast. A night for sleep and a breakfast, a meal for breakfast. So, a breakfast and full board. Okay? Yeah. 5. Listen and repeat the following mini tasks. Pay attention to the tone in the question. Ah, here pronunciation. Okay? Alright, so now you listen and how the tongue of the sentence go. Is go up or is go down? Listen and mark.
1. Where would you like to go sightseeing?
I'd like to go to Australia most of all.
2. What do you think of the newly discovered cave?
Oh, fantastic.
3. Have you been sightseeing all day?
Yeah, we've been to the old pagoda, the orchid garden, and the open air market.
4. Is Egypt a famous tourist attraction?
Yes, millions of people go there every year.
Can you map Tom? Go up or down? Yeah. Once again, listen. And mark, and I'll help you.
1. Where would you like to go sightseeing?
Sightseeing. Go down. Right?
I'd like to go to Australia most of all.
2. What do you think of the newly discovered cave?
Newly discovered cave. Go down. Right?
Oh, fantastic.
3. Have you been sightseeing all day?
All day. All day. Down, then up. Day. Day. Down, up.
Yeah. We've been to the old pagoda, the orchid garden, and the open air market.
4. Is Egypt a famous tourist attraction?
Yes.
Attraction, down then up at the end.
Millions of people go there every year.
Okay, so number one down, number two down, number three down up, number four down up. So what's the rules here? Now, look here. W8 question. So normally in W8 question, the tongue goes down at the end of the question. But here, yes, no question. Okay. So yes, no question. Normally, the tongue go up at the end. Down, then up. Up at the end of the sentence. Okay. That's the normal rule, right? It's basic rule, right? Okay. Now, we move to activity 6. Mark the questions with a falling rising arrows and practice the conversation with a partner. Oh, so falling, the tongue go down. Falling rising, the tongue go down then up. Okay, here is the conversation between Martin and Janet. So you read and you mark the tongue, falling, go down, or falling, rising, go down, then up. And then you listen, and then you practice with your partner. Yes, it's kind of easy. Like in W8 question, normally the tongue go down, falling, and in yes no question, normally the tongue go down then up, that falling rising. Okay, so it's kind of easy, right? So can you mark it? Yes, easy. Now you listen.
Mark the questions with falling or falling rising arrows, and practice the conversation with a partner. Then listen to check your pronunciation. What's the matter, Janet?
I'm looking for my passport. It seems to be lost.
Have you already searched your purse?
Not yet. Oh, where are my glasses?
They may be in your plastic bag. Where is it?
Oh no, it's not here. Have I dropped it on the plane?
Oh my God.
What should I do now?
Let's report it to the customs officer.
Okay, so here, down, down, up, down, 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 up, down. Right? Easy. So you practice reading the conversation with your partner. Okay? Alright, so a close look one. Unit I tourism is finished here. Thank you for watching. Bye bye, and see you in a closed loop 2.